I joke about this, but I think the hardest thing for people to understand is the major, because they don't recognize it as work, is the major work you do is looking out the window with your eyes blank. Because you do a great deal, you know, of thinking, and you try to get something down on paper and you go back and forth to it. I write in a very agonizingly long kind of a way. I'll get some ideas and put them down. I'll put them aside for a while, days, weeks, whatever, bring them back. When I've written them, I thought they were just what I wanted to say. When I look at them again, I realize how badly, in many cases, I've said them, or how I missed the thought, or how I didn't even have the thought that, you know, that I wanted. And so I have drawers full of envelopes with sort of half-started things, and I'll never get to them in three lifetimes, but I get to some of them, and it's interesting. I almost have the feeling sometimes when I open a drawer, and if I lean down and listen, there'll be one of them saying, me, me, me. And that's the one I should take out, you know, and start to work. And sometimes you're ready that way. The new book, the Odious Ogre, was a little story I started close to 40 years ago. It was in one of those big folding, well, they weren't envelopes, they were big folders with closed ends, you know, that I love because you can put a lot of stuff in them. And I would take it out periodically and I'd look at it and I said, there's something there, you know, I like it, but I haven't got it yet. And then about two and a half years ago, maybe three, I took it out and I suddenly said, yeah, I think I know where this is going or what I should do with it. And I began working and I kept working on it. But there are other ones that are in there that'll never see the light of day.